LMU, Application Graphical User Interface. In this session, we would like to explain the most important elements and views of the Application Graphical User Interface. Starting first with the application overview, and explaining the different information in the title pane view. In this part, we will show how the user interface of the tool is structured and what the individual views mean. When starting the license management utility, the tool always opens with the activatable items and entitlement identification item selected in the navigation pane. The user interface is divided in different sections, so-called panes. On top, there is the title pane. The navigation pane on the left side in the middle. A selected item here either opens a view pane view, settings pane view, contextual pane view, or updates view items. Below the navigation pane there is the stack pane, used for selecting views and corresponding tree. The view pane hosts the activate line items view, the settings view, and the licensed products view. The operation pane area mainly contains the buttons, etc. to initiate an operation. The status bar shows the progress of an executed feature. The title pane shows many useful information. We would like to show what they mean. Before we start to have a closer look to the information in the title pane, the application displays the installed version next to the application name on top of the tool frame, in our case the version 2.6. Now let's have a closer look to the information in the title pane. This area displays the different states of the LMU web service connected to the utility. In this case, it is the released state as a white circle and therefore not visible. If you move the mouse pointer over this area, a tooltip will appear confirming the status. As shown in the table, it can have four different colors: white, yellow, orange, and red. Please have a look to the description for the different states. In cases where the color of the circle changes, it is possible that additionally a note appears, next to the Siemens logo. This example shows the note for the yellow circle. With the orange circle status, this note will appear. Or with the red circle status, this note will appear. The customer site identification CSID. Each installation at a customer site needs a valid license and is identified by the customer site ID. It is a unique identification. It is generated during the ordering process and is included in the email produced by the tool and sent to the license receiver. The CSID is displayed in the tool if the license is enabled and if it forces the CSID to be displayed. Here the tool shows the logged-in user and the device name used. In this LMU version, the health state of the trusted store has been introduced. The trusted store icon and tooltip text will change depending on the health state. The following table shows the different health state of the trusted store. The license management system differentiates between trusted and untrusted environments. Three modes are possible according to an environment on site. In the operation mode full, user can access all the activation methods. Full operation mode supports both trusted store and certificate license. The typical use cases are physical machines and the supported virtual environments explained in the chapter introduction of this learning. We call it trusted environments. All untrusted environments are running in restricted mode and will be displayed so. No local trust store is available. Thus, no trust store licenses can be activated, deactivated, etc. In this case, the use of dongle certificate licenses are supported. However, also remote use of licenses are possible as the licenses concerned are installed on a trusted environment. LMU can also be configured as a license server. In this case, the LMU in the license server is responsible for all license operations and acts in operation mode full. And the LMU in the other machines are pointing to the license server in operation mode remote. For more information, Please refer also to the session Virtual Environments in the chapter Introduction of this learning and the help documentation. The License Management Utility shows the actual day, date and time in long format. The menu contains the three items shown here. This help item calls up the online help documentation of the LMU application. The About item displays the About box, which contains various LMU parameters, specifically version information, FNC device ID information, ZIP installed base information, LMS EULA and third-party legal documents. With exit, the application closes. For more information, please refer to the online help documentation in section LMU menu. As already known, LMS supports licensing of various products. The subscription expiration date is only displayed when the customer is offered product license renewal. In order to get new software versions, new features, and bug fixes, a site must have an active subscription. An active subscription is a subscription expiration date that is in the future. Please note, in earlier versions, the site value was also visible here in addition to the subscription expiration date. This value is now displayed in the page CSID attributes, along with other information. See the SUOR subscription renewal section of this tutorial to learn more about what this information means and what the tool offers to enable renewal. These two buttons are used to start or stop actions in the licensing process. More about these in the next chapters. The other panes and their functionality will be shown in connection with the following parts of the learning. For this reason, we end this part here.